Today we are going to discuss about projection of points. So welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So let's take one example. Draw projection of following points. 1. Point R is 10 mm behind VP and 20 mm above HP. 2nd point S is in HP and 22 mm in front of VP. And 3rd point T is 20 mm in front of VP and 25 mm below HP. The weightage in the examination is 3 max. So let's start first from the point R. So first of all, draw the horizontal line, that is your HP, and then draw the vertical line, that is your VP. HP means horizontal plane, VP means vertical plane. Now first we want to locate the point R with respect to VP and HP. So that is given to you 10 mm behind VP. So this is VP and 10 mm behind VP. So here draw the line, that is 10 mm behind VP and then 20 mm above HP. So this is HP, so 20 mm above HP. So this is the 20 mm. So I can mention over here, this is 20 mm above HP. And so that your intersection of these two lines, that is actually the location of the point R. So you can locate the point R is over here. So give the name of this point as R. Now the position of the observer. So this is the position of the observer. So if you look at in this direction, then your projection of the point R, that is on VP, and that's why it is called as the elevation. Sometimes it is called as the front view. So elevation or front view, that is always denoted by dash. And if it is on the projection of horizontal plane or vertical plane, then it is always with small letter. So here I can say this is the small letter R, that is on VP, that's why it should be with dash. So now if you look at from this R dash from here, then your projection is on VP. So your point R is seems to be over here. And the position of R dash, that is 20 mm above HP. Now the observer is changed. So observer is over here. So in this direction you can see it is a top view. Sometimes it is known as the plan. So from this direction, if I want to see the point R, then the projection is on HP. So if the projection is on HP, then it should be denoted with small r. So this is small r, and your small r is seems to be over here on HP from this direction, and that is with respect to this vertical line 10 mm. So I can denote over here the point R. Now as you know that always your HP, that means horizontal plane, is rotated in clockwise direction. So now I'll rotate this HP in clockwise direction. So your R is move here. So what should be this distance? That is exactly equal to this 10 mm. Because of it is actually rotated in clockwise direction. So from here to here, this distance is also 10. So now this is actually the projection of point R, that is R dash and R. So this is actually the rough figure to understand the position of the R and R dash. Now I want to draw the same thing with the instrument. So now exactly with the instrument. So first draw the XY line, that is this line, and with respect to this line your R and R dash, that is on the same vertical line. So first draw the vertical line. On this vertical line, look at the point R and R dash. So first this is your R dash, that is 20 mm above this XY line. So mention over here 20 mm. And that is exactly you have to draw with the help of this scale. So you have to take this dimension with the help of this scale 20 mm and so that you can locate the point R dash. Similarly, this distance is 10 mm. So exactly with the help of the scale, you have to mention the point R, that is above XY line 10 mm. So this is the projection of point R. This is very simple. So keep in mind that in the examination that this drawing is with the help of the instrument and this is your rough figure to take the basic idea of the position of R and R dash. So now let's turn for the point S. So once again draw the horizontal plane and vertical plane. Point S is in HP, means on this horizontal line, anywhere point S will be there. Now 22 mm in front of VP. So this is VP and in front of VP, that means on this side 22 mm. So draw the line 22 mm and so that now you can decide this is the intersection of this vertical line and horizontal line. So the location of the point S is over here. So locate the point S. Now position of observer. So the position of the observer is over here. and show that the projection on VP and show that it should be with the dash. So it is S dash, and S dash is seems to be over here on VP in this direction. So this is the position of S dash. Now I can mark the point over here. Now observer is over here. So this is your top view and your projection is on HP. So this is without dash S, and this S is with small letter. Now as you know that your horizontal plane is always rotated in clockwise direction. So I am going to rotate this horizontal plane. So your S is move from this position to this position. So once again this is 22 mm, so from here to here this is also 22 mm. So now this is the location of the point S dash and S, and that is nothing but the projection of point S. So this is all the rough figure. So now I am going to draw the same thing of S and S dash with the instrument. So draw XY line first. You know that S and S dash on the same vertical line, so this is your vertical line. Now look at first of all S dash, then this is 22 mm, obviously this is also 22 mm. So with the help of this scale you can locate the point S and give the dimension as 22 mm. So this is actually the projection of point S, that is what S and S dash. So this figure only you have to draw in the examination. So now it's the turn for the last point, point T. So first of all draw the horizontal plane and vertical plane, HP and VP. Now point T is 20 mm in front of VP, so with respect to VP 20 mm, so draw the line that is 20 mm in front of VP and 25 mm below HP. So 25 mm below HP, so this is HP, below HP 25 mm, so this is 25. So now the intersection of these two lines, that I can give the name as point T, that is over here. So give the name as T. So that is actually the location of the point T. Now with reference to the observer position, so this is the position of observer, and from this direction the projection is on VP, that's why it should be T dash. Now T dash seems to be like over here from this direction, so I can look it over here. So mark the point T dash. Now the observer is over here, and that is actually top view, or you can say plan. And so that the projection is on HP of this point T, and that's why it is small t. Now projection from here on HP of point T, that is over here. So I can mark the point T is over here. Now as you know that the HP is always rotated in clockwise direction, so I will rotate the HP and so that your T is moved from here to here. This is 20, so obviously this distance is also 20. So this is the position of T and T dash. So once you decide this position of T and T dash, and then you can draw with the help of the instrument. So this is all the rough figure actually. So now with the instrument, draw the horizontal line, give the name as XY, draw the vertical line, because of the on this vertical line T and T dash are there. So now look at the point T and T dash with the help of the scale. So first of all, this is the point T. This distance is 20, so obviously this distance is also 20. Below XY line 20 mm is there, so I can mention over here also. Then T dash, that is below XY line 25 mm, so this is the position of the T dash and the distance is 25 mm. So this is the projection of the point T, that is T and T dash. So that portion that only you have to draw in the examination, that is the projection of point T. So it is very simple to draw the projection of point. So thanks my dear friends. So now it's the turn for the last point, point T. So first of all draw the horizontal plane and vertical plane, HP and VP. Now point T is 20 mm in front of VP, so with respect to VP 20 mm, so draw the line that is 20 mm in front of VP and 25 mm below HP. So 25 mm below HP, so this is HP, below HP 25 mm, so this is 25. So now the intersection of these two lines, that I can give the name as point T, that is over here, so give the name as T. So that is actually the location of the point T. Now with reference to the observer position, so this is the position of observer, and from this direction the projection is on VP, that's why it should be T dash. Now T dash seems to be like over here from this direction. So I can look it over here. So mark the point T dash. Now the observer is over here, and that is actually top view, or you can say plan. And so that the projection is on HP of this point T, and that's why it is small t. Now projection from here on HP of point T, that is over here. So I can mark the point T is over here. Now as you know that the HP is always rotated in clockwise direction, so I will rotate the HP, and so that your T is moved from here to here. This is 20, so obviously this distance is also 20. So this is the position of T and T dash. So once you decide this position of T and T dash, and then you can draw with the help of the instrument. So this is all the rough figure actually. So now with the instrument, draw the horizontal line, give the name as XY, draw the vertical line, because of the on this vertical line T and T dash are there. So now look at the point T and T dash with the help of the scale. So first of all, this is the point T. This distance is 20, so obviously this distance is also 20. Below XY line 20 mm is there, so I can mention over here also. Then T dash, that is below XY line 25 mm. So this is the position of the T dash, and the distance is 25 mm. So this is the projection of the point T, that is T and T dash. So that portion that only you have to draw in the examination, that is the projection of point T. So it is very simple to draw the projection of point. So thanks my dear friends.